lately we have been covering consistently issues around migration and refugees. We work on hate crimes against migrants, Roma, LGBTI people. We also work a lot on issues around police violence and ill treatment. This is where we describe what happens at the borders. It's Europe's borders, you know? You know, this is the borders with Turkey. Almost daily, refugees, many refugees from Syria with children, try to enter, and the Greek Coast Guard or the Greek police just arrest them and send them back immediately to Turkey. That's a pushback. During this operation, ill treatment is abundant. Almost all the people we talk to have either experienced or witnessed ill treatment. And we're talking about slapping, kicking, beating even small children at some times. Their possessions are confiscated, they're taken away, their money, watches, expensive mobiles, and they never see them back. They never return. These people are sent summarily back. The way this pushback is performed put their lives in additional danger. They leave them in little boats, unseaworthy boats. I mean, they're plastic boats of 6-7 meters with a very little motor. Like, you can see 30, 40, 50 people on board this boat. But yet there is a small motor. When the Greek Coast Guard apprehends them, that's what the people tell us. They stop them. Sometimes, very often, they put them on their boat, on the Coast Guard boat. And then they put them back, they strip them, they search them, they put them back on their own vessel. They remove the motor, or the row sometimes they have. They take away the gasoline, just push them to the Turkish territorial water and just leave them there. Sometimes the Turkish Coast Guard arrives or sees them. Sometimes they call themselves, and this happens again. I mean, I have cases, people who were pushed back like that 4 or 5 times. That's a flagrant violation of international, European, and Greek law. No question about it. And because we're talking about people, what you see, who are these people? What happens there in the sea while most of us are asleep? During the night, we have families, children, babies as young as 3 or 4 months old, old women, as old as my grandmother, wearing same scarf, very often remind me of my grandmother. I mean, sometimes I try to think what evil they saw, what made them run like that, because, I mean, there's no turning back from them, you can see, they're not looking back. The very first year, the first year or second where I started talking to them, many of them were hoping that they would go back. Now, you see them, they have no hope. I mean, it's probably because the situation is getting worse and worse. And these are the people, many of those people, who are being treated like that. But even once they make it to Greece, let's say they managed, they avoided all the dangers, all the perils, and they made it safely to Greece. The main plank, the main aspect of Greece's migration policy is detention. Now, people are detained for up to 18 months. Imagine they have not committed any crime. I mean, they just enter the country with no documents, irregularly. Fine, I mean, Greece, like any other country, has a right to control its borders. The problem is, where do you put the accent? How do you balance the rights? So you have people who have not committed any crime, and yet they're locked up for 18 months. To be locked up for 18 months, deprived of your liberty for 18 months, you have to commit a serious crime. A serious thing, it's not about it. So, but these people are routinely detained for 18 months, awaiting deportation. There are many cases of ill treatment in these detention centers. The detention conditions are below the international standards, are very, very difficult. And this is how these people are treated when they try to enter Europe. Even if they have the documents, they can end up 4, 5, 6 times within a day sometimes in the police station just to have their documents checked in and out. It's very difficult to even walk the streets. Many people tell me, if I don't have something urgent to do, I try to avoid to go out. You know, the fact that persons are taken to the police station for check like 2 or 3 or 4 days, it's just abusive. It just goes beyond control, beyond what is legitimate to control. And also, you can see the statistics of the police. The majority of the people have documents, they are not. It's just taken back and forth. I mean, it very often it looks like the only they want to is to apply pressure to them. You know, so it is discriminatory. It's profiling what they're doing, you see. You look like that. I mean, I was never controlled.
Thank you.
problem behind it is a very weak political will to deal with that thing. And why? Because we have persistent impunity. We have what I call a culture of impunity within the police and the Coast Guard. I mean, as long as you don't deal with that, as long as people or officers, of course, the majority of the police officers are not perpetrating ill-treatment or torture or beating the people, but those who do have to face justice, have to be held accountable. A strong signal has to be sent and the institutional guarantees have to be put in place. At the borders with Turkey, we have hundreds of deaths also. Why? Because people have to cross. People are taking more and more dangerous route. So making it more difficult, you're actually sending money to smugglers because these people will have to pay smugglers and just increase the dangers they have to take, resulting in deaths. Since the Greece has deployed all this coast guard, all this police its border, you see that a big number of refugees and migrants is now trying to cross through Bulgaria. I mean, you're not solving the problem, you're just pushing it from one border to the other. For many of them, Greece is just a step, it's just a stop before another destination. So basically many of them are trapped. And here also comes the whole European aspect of it. Actually what we're seeing from Europe is what we call, I mean, you've heard the term before, is a fortress Europe. Just a set of norms who designed to keep people, refugees and migrants out. So it's becoming more and more difficult. There are no, or very little, very no way you can enter a refugee to enter through a lawfully in Greek or international and European territory to demand their rights, which is asylum. So that's increasingly happening, and that's increasingly the trend in Europe. Countries who face more pressures from irregular migration and refugees, they should be supported more. We don't think that Europe as a whole is doing enough. Of course, this does not devoid, is not taking away any responsibility from what the Greece authorities are doing. Ill-treatment is never excused. There's no European who comes and tells them, like, if you ill-treat. That's what the Greek Coast Guard or the Greek police is doing. But still, you have to look also to the general picture, and the general picture in Europe is very, very concerned. The whole approach of Europe vis-à-vis migration and refugees is becoming more and more restrictive. It's just Europe is becoming a fortress that is impossible to breach, impossible to enter. There are no lawful ways. You blame somebody for trying to enter unlawfully, but there's no lawful way. You have the rights to apply for asylum, but it's very difficult for people, getting increasingly difficult to enter. And what is the outcome of it? It's deaths. It's the bodies we collect in Lampedusa and the Aegean Sea. People will try and take more and more dangerous route. It's not solving. So, yes, the European Union and the member states have the right to control their borders, but there has to be a more balanced approach. I think that is possible.